to prima.net. There we go. I'll prima.net. If you click on that, you'll see, if you go into the blog, I think it is, you'll see that there's currently Banzai. Hey, how are you doing? I'm sat down at a desk. This isn't right. Yes. Hey, Blue Just Blue. Bonjour. How are you, my friend? Yeah, this is different. This is very different, isn't it? The last time I sat down at a desk was with Fiend when I made this t-shirt, which some of you saw, probably. So anyway, the alaprima.net, you'll see that there's a current contest. It's a mixed media contest, so anything that you want to create in any form whatsoever, sculpture, painting, printing, even digital, as long as you mix the media. So you can't just use digital, you have to use digital with some sort of drawing, painting, sculpting, media, or you can just mix any two media. You can do pen and ink and watercolor, you can do pencil and charcoal, and I don't know, you can do whatever you want. But anyway, that was due to close on Tuesday, I think was the last day. I mean, on Wednesday was the last day for it. But they've extended it, partially because I said I wanted to enter, but I hadn't had time because I needed to finish this piece you see behind me. So anyway, this is what I'm doing. I'm doing a linoleum cut, and then I'm going to print it, and then I'm going to hand color it with watercolor. So this is the piece that I'm working from. This is a photograph I took. It's very, very high contrast here. You can't really see it very well. This is a photograph I took of some statues that line the entryway. Chloe, how are you? Thank you for the host. Awesome. Thank you very much. Oh, Chloe, it's your stream. Did you finish? Are you finished, Chloe? Or are you going on later? Because you're over in America, is that right, Chloe? Anyway, if you finished your stream, tell me how it went. I'm sorry I missed it. I just got home. All's Welsh that ends Welsh. Dig Lebowski, how are you? Oh, it's a raid from the lovely Chloe. How are you? Simply, how are you? Aw, it's the crew. High Wind, hello, how are you? Is this a Chloe raid? All's Welsh that ends Welsh. Is Chloe Welsh? I didn't even know that. I'll get my rare bit. I'll get my Welsh rare bit going. Hey, you guys are awesome. Hey, Instinct's dead. How are you? Twiggly Bits, hey, how's it going? Yay! Cute Chloe raid. You guys are so cute. Chloe, where's Chloe? I want to say hi to Chloe. Chloe, I love you. You're so sweet. Oh, I'm so sorry. I just got home, had some dinner, and then got this set up. So I haven't even had a chance to watch any Twitch tonight. I really wanted to be there for the Chloe party. You guys dancing? Should we get some dance music going so we can keep the party going? Simply, thank you for the host. Right on, Instincts. I'm glad you're doing well. Okay, I'm going to leave this to run out through the rest of Abbey Road, and then I'll put on the party time music, so paperwork to transport. So anyway, thanks guys. Thank you so much for the raid, and thank you Chloe. And thank you Colette for the follow. Way to go. So, for any of my viewers, my regular viewers who are used to seeing me standing up and painting oil paints, this is different. This is the first time I've ever sat down on my stream. Aw, thank you for the follow. Thank you, Instinct's Dead. Cheers to you. Cheers to the orange juice. You like the gift? Do you like my cat being caught at the laptop? How's it going, Fiend? How are you? I was just talking about the last time I was sitting down in a stream was when I sat down next to you and printed this t-shirt by hand. So how was the Chloe stream, guys. I've been anticipating that, and I missed it. I'm so sad. I didn't realize it'd be so early because I didn't actually know that Chloe was Welsh. And I didn't know she was on the same time zone as me. I thought she was in America. I don't know why I assumed that. So yeah, anyway, what's happening? What's happening? I'm not standing up. I'm not painting. Well, what's happening is that A La Prima, the part of the creative streamer team that I am a member of, is currently having a contest for mixed media. So I've explained this a couple times now, but I'm just recapping. Chloe, the most nervous and terrified you've ever been. Oh, Chloe! I'm gonna go on and check out the video as soon as I get off. I'm gonna check out the video of the stream, because I am so sorry I missed it. How was the music? Oh, shout out to Chloe. Yes, totally. Taco, would you mind giving... Yeah, you've shouted her out already. Thanks. Yeah, Fiend says it was great, Chloe, so I'm sure it was great. Fiend, don't lie. When does the contest end again, Chicken? It ends next week on Wednesday, I believe. If you go to the alaprima.net website, check out the blog. You'll see there all the rules, and I believe Rezo has updated the date, but if it says that it was already over this week, it's not already over, I'm telling you now. Oh, Abbey Road is just finished. I need to put on the party time music. Here we go. I'm going to keep the party rolling, the Chloe party. Let's not start with Aha, though. Let's start with... No. Yes. Yes. We're going to start with some Depeche Mode tonight. Hey, Ikarioth! How are you? So, end of the month, yes, on A La Prima. Okay, cool. So, end of the month. The reason I'm sitting down today is because I'm gonna enter the A La Prima Mixed Media Contest. And what I'm doing is a lino cut. It's a linoleum cut. For those of you who don't know, lino cut means linoleum cut. What it is a piece of linoleum, which is actually just kind of like a sheet of rubber. And it's thick enough that I can cut into it with this little tool, which has different size cutting and edges on it, and I can change those. Got a few different nibs here that will gouge out different widths, basically, and different shapes. Oh, you're going to enter Chicken. All right, perfect. We need as many entries as we can get. There is a 20-pound, I think there's a $20 prize for Amazon gift vouchers, which Rezo, I think, has kindly put up. And hoping to get lots of people entering. So anybody who's watching, Fiend, come on, you guys. Taco, Chloe, anybody who can do anything that has more than one media, pencil, paint, sculpture, digital versus digital with a little bit of drawing on it, or a little bit of watercolor on it, anything. That's all valid. And just do what you do and send it in to Rezo. He's given his email address on the website, and you can just send it right in. The judges will be... I was going to judge it, actually, but I decided I would rather enter it this time. So I think, maybe, Twiggly, I think the judges might be Rezo and Trio Gaming, possibly. Rezo and two others, yeah. Diggs there with the information. You thought rubbers were erasers? They are, Big Lebowski. They're erasers and contraceptives. But this is a piece of rubber rather than a rubber itself. Trio! You're not judging? Hey, how are you, Trio? Sorry to put that burden on you without your knowledge. I wasn't sure whether you were wanting to judge it or whether you're going to enter it. Oh, you're the first to enter. You haven't yet. Might soon, though. Are you talking about entering, Fiend? So, anyway, guys, I'm going to get started here. I've already started, as you can see. And for those who weren't here earlier when I started talking about this, what I'm doing is this photograph I took, which is pretty complex for a linoleum cut, but I'm all about jumping in and trying it. I mean, I've done some linoleum cuts in the past, so I'm familiar with it, but I'm not great at it. I wouldn't say I'm great at it. So, oh, you've got an idea, Taco? Right on. Jenny's a tough cookie. Well, so is Rezzo. They're both tough with judging, but they're fair. I mean, they'll be honest and they'll be fair. You just gotta have a, you know, tough backbone, and I'm ready for the criticism too. So don't fear. It's all friendly. We're all here to like create together, you know. Jenny has crushed many artists' souls in the past. I'm surprised by that. I mean, yeah, you know. She says how it is, but she's also a very kind person, a nice person. So maybe she doesn't pull the punches. I haven't seen that. So anyway, this is a photograph I took. These are two statues, which I think are just beautiful, and they are the entryway to this kind of city council building in Deptford, southeast London, very near where I've painted and have a studio for many years. It's actually where quite a few famous bands come from, this area of London. The biggest one, Dire Straits, from this area of London. So this is from Dire Straits' Hood. So yeah, I'm going to attempt to cut this out of linoleum. So what I did was I traced this whole photograph, printed it out, traced it in graphite, put it face down on here. Now, actually, what I did was put a piece of transfer paper down and then traced it on to here, so I transferred on. You can do it both ways, though. You can coat the back of the drawing with graphite, stick it down and then trace it, and then it'll transfer onto the linoleum quite well. So yeah, you must stream. That's a very important rule there, as you'll see on the Olipreme website. You have to stream whatever you create. You can't create it behind the scenes. That's part of it. That's the whole Olipreme ethos, is we get to see the process. That's an important part of it. The only drawings I don't stream are the ones you do in class. Cool. So markers and colored pencils would be eligible? Yes, it would, Chicken Bish. Yes, it would. That's mixed media. Those are two different things. Okay. So, where I'm at with this is I've transferred the drawing. I started a couple months ago, I started this, and I kind of put it aside. And I don't own my own tools. These are pretty expensive, these tools, so I had to borrow them, and I didn't have access to them for a while, but now I do. So, now that I'm here and I'm back, I'm going to keep going on this. So the way it works is you cut out all of the parts that you want to remain white, and you leave all the parts that you want to be black. And then, I've got this roller. I'll put printing ink, and there's special kinds of printing inks. I've got some here, I've got orange, I've got this black, I've got a black, and I've got a brown, like a sepia, sienna. And you roll it on, and it doesn't get into the grooves. And then when you print it, you've got a black and white, or whatever color you want, and the color of the paper. You know exactly what you'll do, but it's a secret. Okay, well, we can't hear what's in your mind, so don't worry, I can't tell anybody anyway, even if I want to. So guys, sit back, relax, chill out, I'm gonna work on this. And thank you again, Chloe, for the raid, and thank you for being here. And I'm so sorry I missed. So sorry I missed yours. I really wanted to be there for it. Feel bad. So I'm starting with kind of the thin line work, and then I'm going to start gouging out like bigger areas later. But so far, I've just done really thin stuff. So let's see if I can get back onto where I was when I left this last. Getting the bricks done. And this stuff's kind of easy to like, it's easy to mess up. I'll be honest, this is not one of the forgiving media. Oh, thank you, Chloe, you're so sweet. I was so looking forward to it. I should have asked you what time you were gonna be on so I could, I had some drinks with friends after work. It was something I agreed to a long time ago, and I couldn't really snub them. And I just got home, got cleaned up, made dinner, and then started streaming. So I didn't have any time to kind of check in and see what was going on Twitch-wise. I'm approaching this kind of the same way that I approach my paintings, though. I'm probably a little overly cautious, trying to make sure that I get the right effect. Simply. Trio in the house. Trio Gaming. Shout her out. Trio Gaming. Oh no, what happened? Shout out. I'm not in my normal like typing position either, so it's tough. What the fuck did I do? Oh, I know what I did. I put the exclamation point after. If I don't get it right this time, I'm gonna give up. 4-1-4. Did I get it? Boom, there we go. Trio. And Chloe, thank you so much for the shout out for Chloe. Can we get one for Fiend too? I just want to shout out all the awesome people, and I need to shout out Simply as well. You guys are all awesome. I want to get the shout outs out of the way. No, I can't do it. Guys, I can't type tonight. I've had 3 beers. Help me out. Can I leave this to you, Taco? Maybe. Don't follow Simply. What? Simply, there will be no self-deprecation in my stream. Yeah, one thing I also wouldn't recommend is going out and having 3 pints and coming home and doing linoleum cuts. This is kind of like a slightly technical form of art. And I'm sure I'm gonna fuck it up. But I also don't believe in fucking it up. I just think it'll, you know, I'll work with it, whatever happens here. My drawing's a little bit smudged. It's hard for me to see what I'm doing. So, this one's for Chloe. This one's totally for Chloe. Thank you, Taco. So we got Trio. We got Simply. We need Fiend. We need a shout out for Fiend. Because I totally fucked it up. Get drunk and do art. Get drunk and do art. I'm not drunk. I'm definitely not drunk. But I'm not, like, you know, completely sober either. No.
reckon them there all scratched. Nobody listens to the word I say.
You did, okay. So shmammied. I'm also trying to read my computer from a little bit further back, and I've got a table in front of me, and I can't get any closer, so it's a little bit like...
Don't care, so I won't cry.
You say, well, I'm light in the tipsy. That's exactly where I'm at. Trying to work out all these lines here and what I'm going to do and how I'm going to pull this off.
Can't stand losing you.
Has anybody out there ever done linoleum cutting? And if so, how did you find it? It's not one of those things that's like commonly done. I don't see a lot of people working in linoleum. I see a lot of people working like lithography or maybe screen printing or even woodcut. Woodblock. This is similar to woodcut, except for it's like an easier version for the people who don't want to chisel into wood all the time. Don't have any alcohol? Be going to sleep. Okay, chicken, I won't have any more alcohol since you said that. Trio, you were sweeping? Working and lurking and twerking? Yes! That's amazing. You were sweeping and twerking? That's talent, Trio. We were just shouting you out here. That's all. So Trio, what did you do for this mixed media challenge? Sounds like we got a few more people that might enter, which is good. You've done a handful of them in your high school art class. Cool. How did they turn out? Did you like it? It's a lot of fun, I find. It's interesting. It's difficult. It's not the easiest one to do. I don't think I'm going to get to the point of actually printing this tonight. Hopefully I'll get finished with the cutting. And then next time I'll print and watercolor. Cookie Craft, hey, how are you? Thank you very much. It's really fun. It's definitely a lot of fun. You kind of have to think in reverse. It's a little bit tough. Not in reverse, but you have to think about everything you're going to cut away, because that's it. Once it's gone, it's gone. You can't print it. There we go, that's okay. these lines are not going to be really precise, but that's kind of the charm of these things, is they're not precise. They've got a little bit of waviness to them. Unless you're like completely pro at doing it and you're really anal. And you want to get that really tight look. But no, I'm about being loose. I want to try to keep this interesting so you can see all the different hand done work in it. I'm still trying to stay true to the work that I like to do, though. Like, even though I'm working in a different medium, I'm... Hey, Cookie Craft, thank you so much for the follow. Thank you, lovely. Yeah, I'm still trying to work within subject matter that I really am interested in. Twerking was how they were sleeping. Are you there, Highwind? Are you there with Trio, by any chance? Can you bear witness to this twerking? All these little thin lines are really tough. See if you can see what I'm doing there. Can you see the dimensionality? You can kind of see how blurry those lines I'm working with are. So I'm just trying to really look at the photograph that I'm working from and gauge how I'm going to make it look, right? So I'm cutting away anything that I want to remain light. So I'm going to take away big sections here, here, over here. Nope. Need to remove that from my playlist, actually. Don't want that one on there. Tools had a lot of traffic, so they weren't always as sharp as they should be. So it was quite a struggle to get the cuts you wanted. I was just thinking about that. This is really sharp, but if it wasn't, I would really be struggling right now, especially to do this kind of fine line stuff. Guys, I need to crank this song. I'm going to crank it just a bit. I want to make sure you can enjoy this song as much as I am going to. This song always gets me. Oh, Amber, how are you? Hey, lovely, how are you? I know, this totally feeling you on this song. Such a classic. Just takes me back to my childhood. Heat of the moment too. Oh, right on. Do I have heat of the moment on here? I don't think I have that song on my 80s playlist. Thank you for making sure that my 80s playlist is not bare of all the soul in his heart. I need it at the moment. Yeah. Reminds you of a little pyrography. What's a pyrography? I don't know about that one. And a lithography. Photography. Pyrography is a new one for me. Is that like burning? Is like stencil burning? I'm not strictly doing this the way that it should be done. I mean, I'm doing it fine, but I think I should have like an X-Acto knife, and I could be cutting the ends of these as I come up to them to get a nice clean cut. But I'm not really going for super clean. It's definitely going to have some character to it. Probably a lot of character, because it's going to be pretty rough. But hopefully the image will come across pretty strong. That's what I'm really hoping for. That people can appreciate what the image is. So you can see how kind of wavery those lines are. So it will feel kind of like a woodcut. I'm trying to take little pieces off just to clean up the lines a little bit, but it doesn't really do that very well. Pyrography is to use fire and heated instruments to illustrate and etch. Cool, awesome, yeah. Oh, awesome. Thanks, Chloe. Yeah, I figured it was like stencil burning or something like that. Or like wood burning with a hot needle kind of thing. I just wasn't sure. I hadn't ever heard referred to as pyrography. So thank you for teaching me. Always learning something new. Remember. She got turned up nose. She turned up nose. Chip Whitehouse, hello, my friend. How are you? Thanks for stopping by. How are you doing tonight? Crew's here. I think this is like the coolest kids on Twitch in my stream right now. I'm not kidding. This is like a conglomeration of awesomeness. Thank you guys so much for being here, making me feel special. Because I do. Chip, what are you trying to say there? What are you trying to say? Are you trying to post a link? We can give you a permission if you'd like. Third time, yo, Fiend at Kaleidofam. Chip, are you part of the Kaleidoscope family? Sorry, I'm sorry the Moonbot was avoid excessive APs, please. APs, what the fuck? Or caps, is it caps? Oh, caps, I see. Wasn't even caps. I'm sorry, Chip. That was unintentional. Oh yeah, I'm feeling it. Feeling some Faith No More tonight. This takes me back to the days of hanging out with Fiend. As a teenager, walking down the street, singing this song word for word. I'm doing really, really well. Thank you, Chip, for asking. I am in real life friends with Dean. We are currently still friends. We're still best friends after over 30 years. We met in second grade. Been tight friends ever since. We even lived together at one point, shared an apartment. acting. And I just never considered really doing it for painting, you know, like traditional painting. I thought it was mostly like illustrators and digital artists. I hadn't really seen very many people doing like the full setup with oil paints, and I didn't know how it was going to work for me, but he told me to do it and I did it and it worked. Yeah, Chloe. Yeah, it's okay. You can give me props for Fiend, but it's Fiend that deserves all the credit for being who he is. But I'm happy to take credit for being the vehicle that got Fiend to you. So Fiend, from me to you. Twitch would not be the same without Fiend. That's true. That Fiend face and that Fiend voice. When did I start streaming? In October. Like, I think it was early October. November, December, January. So 4 months. I've been going 4 months. But I haven't been going like super frequently because I got a day job and I got a child, baby, 7-month-old. I got Mrs. Night Sky, so you know, I've got a family to kind of try to keep up with and a job to keep up with, so it's tough. So I do as much as I can. I work kind of late into the night sometimes, just trying to keep myself active creatively. And it's definitely motivational for me. It's a motivating factor to have people like you guys out here when I get here to paint, because I get feedback and I get some love and I get some, you know, just people who care about what I'm doing, so it makes it feel like there's something for me to, a reason for me to come in late at night when I'm tired to keep working, you know. I'm sure you guys know what I mean. You streamers. Cute 7-month-old. What happened to my... Oh, it's on shuffle, but we got 2 Billy Idols in a row. So, Spotify wants to hear some Billy Idol. We're gonna let Spotify have some Billy Idol. Fiend, have you ever done this? Have you ever done the linoleum? I think we did it in high school, didn't we? But I wonder if you've ever done it since, because I know it's totally like along the lines of like the stenciling that you do and stuff. Chip's throwing his love around. Thanks for the love, Chip. Love back. Love back to you. Thank you for throwing love into my stream. Wedding. It's a nice day to start again. Hey, little sister, who is it you're looking for? Hey, little sister, what's your fascination? I haven't done lino, only wood print. Yeah, lino I think is just an easier poor man's version of woodcut. Woodcut's harder though, because you have to like really gouge into the wood. I'm gonna have to, now though, after watching this. Oh, cool, yeah. Well, it's fairly inexpensive. The only thing that's expensive is the tools to get. At least they are here. I don't know if they are in America. But I think a set of tools with like a handle and 4 different cutting blades is like £25 here. And then you gotta get the ink. You've got the printing inks. Then you got the roller for rolling the ink on nice and smooth. And then you got the paper, of course, but that's easy. And they're really nice to print and then hand color, like with watercolor, which is what I'm going to be doing after this is printed. I'll color it. Pick it up! Take me like, oh yeah! Who isn't a Fiend fan? Very, very good point. Everybody who knows Fiend loves Fiend. To know him is to love, love, love him. I didn't steal that, I made that up. That's my own copyright. You can't steal that now. All the Fiendings. Just now, it could be from Labyrinth though. It just reminded me immediately of it. Chloe, don't be mad at Fiend. Tune! Yes, total tune. You guys, Fiend and Chloe, I want you to say that you have respect for one another. Mad respect. There's no harm intended there anymore. It's all just a good fun, Chloe. Maybe we'll kiss and make up. Yeah, that's what I like to see. I don't even know how it started. Fiend, you know what I was just thinking about? I don't know why I thought about this for some reason. I guess it was just thinking about the old days when we were talking about the Faith No More song. But one of my favorite memories is going to Fashion Place Mall with you and going to Keyhole to buy joke items. Like, I don't know, I can't remember. Like, I remember I had a piece of gum that you pulled out that yeah, Fiend, I know. Just going to the mall. And I remember getting some gum that looked like Wrigley's or whatever, and you pull it out and it snapped your thumb. Anyway, my point was those are happy memories. I like thinking about those things. I know, I love the keyhole, man. It just makes me happy thinking about going there and hanging out on a Saturday and going to a movie and spending some of our allowance on ridiculous shit. I think I bought like an ice cube that would fly in it. I'm sure I bought a whoopee cushion at some point. It's coming along, guys. Lots of architectural detail. It's a slow process. Yeah, the trick gum. Oh, I also remember getting some trick gum that looked really good but tasted horrible. It was like the precursor to those Harry Potter like jelly beans that smell that taste like vomit and stuff. I think I'm getting slightly better at this as I go, but unfortunately I keep on seeing all the shitty mistakes I made when I first started it. But I guess that's part of it. It's part of growing, developing, and learning. Just gotta accept the fact that you used to suck and you're getting better.
Come on and take this and kick inside.
Ruz, how's it going, my friend? I'm working on my entry for the mixed media competition. How are you? Ah, thank you so much for the host, man. Appreciate it. How's it going tonight? I'm doing something quite ill-advised, which is linoleum cutting while a little bit tipsy after a long day of work while listening to Eurasia. Might not be the best idea, but I'm just gonna do it anyway. Release? Yes. Well, linoleum cut, yeah, relief print. It will be a relief print. And yes, it's a relief that you're here. Thanks for showing up. You can take over now. I was getting a bit tired. So this will be a print in ink, and then watercolor. I'll watercolor it. No, I can't hand Susu to you right now. That's it? You did your test stream rather merry last night? Did you? I thought it was tonight. Was it tonight the stream, Chloe? Or was it last night? You were in a jovial state, were you? There's nothing wrong with that. Oh, test stream last night, official stream tonight. You felt like you shouldn't drink in Twitch ever again. No, you'll get used to it. The more comfortable you get with streaming, the more comfortable you get with while drinking and streaming. It relaxes you. I've only done it a few times, but it's been fine. I think the only problem is just focusing on the artwork while you're doing that. Some people are used to drinking and drawing, drinking and making art. I don't do that often. I always have maybe a beer while I'm, or a glass of wine or something while I'm making art, or drawing, painting, whatever. But I'm not really used to it, actually getting drunk or coming home drunk and trying to paint. You're hammered when you teach? Oh, that's... You teach in bars. Yeah, I was thinking about that, Ruz, actually. Because I don't think that, you know, that thing hasn't... Of, kind of like pub or bar art classes with a live artist has not caught on over here yet. And I was thinking maybe I should try to tap the market while it's still fresh over here and get some, because I know there's a lot of nearby pubs and they probably really love that kind of thing. So I was thinking maybe I should try to find out from you what you do, like how you set it up, how you got involved with it. Even if I was teaching in the bar, though, I don't think I'd be hammered. I'd probably try to maintain some sort of ability to... They'd probably like it, though, if you're hammered. Okay, let's see. This window right here is what I'm dreading. It's going to be a kind of tough job. Totally got the angles wrong on this one. I'm gonna fix it just a bit. Oh, cool. Yeah, that'd be awesome, Ruz. I appreciate that. Love to find out how you got involved in that. You got your song request picked out? Fire it at me, Fiend. Actually, most of this over here is done. Most of this is done. It's just this section down here. A couple little marks over here, probably. I'm definitely going to have to stream one more cutting session. And hopefully at the end of the next cutting session, I'll be able to do Humpty Dance. Yeah! That's on here. That's on my 80s playlist. So next stream, I'm sure I'll finish this off and then print it, and then hopefully even do the watercolor art. There we go, queued up. Yeah, Takame, I feel you. Was that this song? I think this song had the Eric Prydz version of it with the people in the, like, it was like a class, like some sort of jazzercise class. Oh yeah. Hey, Latendris. Hey, Gabby, thank you for the follow. Do you often stream lino carving? Latendris? No. Good question. No, I don't. Usually, what I do is paint oil paintings. So this one behind me is an oil painting I finished last stream. And what I'm doing right now is entering a competition. yeah, this is a fiend request, this song. But I love it. Stoked that you brought it up. So what I'm doing is entering a competition for the Alla Prima art contest of mixed media. So I'm doing something different than what I normally do. I'm just going to put up the allaprima.net web link. Allaprima.net is the website where all the artists who are part of the Alla Prima streaming team of artists can be seen, and on the blog there you can see the details of this contest. It's free for anybody to enter, so anybody who's watching who is a streamer, you have to stream what you're going to enter, but you have like another week, or maybe another 4 or 5 days, till the end of the month basically, to do a piece of mixed media. It can be anything. It can be a painting, a drawing, as long as it has two different forms of media. I don't really know what the judging criteria will be, but it'll probably be just whatever one looks the best when it's done. Doesn't matter how it's done. Whichever one inspires us the most. And of course, I'm trying to do my bit and do something interesting, something different. I don't know a lot of lino cut artists who do architectural stuff, probably because it's not very easy to do and it's labor intensive, not quick, but you know, I don't shy away from doing something that takes time. It usually pays off. It'll dance is your chance, do the hump, 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 do the hump. Check it out. Pushy limp to the side, like his leg was broken. Stumping in, pushing his leg was... People say, look like MC Hammer on crack, Compty. That's alright, cause my body's in motion. It's look like a bitter of commotion. This is my dance, y'all. Humpty Hump's my name. No two people will do it the same. They got it down. Why do you appear to be insane, Humpty? Honkin', jumping, get around, shaking your rock. Step off, I'm doing my hump. Can't believe I remembered so many of the words. I got some of them wrong, but still. Puerto Rican.
Underground is in the house. I'd like to send a shout out to the home.
quite rare on Twitch. That's good to know. Maybe I'll try to do some more since people don't get to see the process very often. It's definitely a fun thing to do, and I think, I mean, I have fun watching people do it. So hopefully it's fun for you guys to watch. So thank you, Latendris, for coming, for stopping and saying hi. Painting is also quite rare on Twitch, that is true. I didn't quite realize, well, I guess I did. When I started painting, I didn't know very many painters on Twitch. When I started painting on Twitch, not when I started painting in general, but. See how it's looking there? Give you an idea of the. I'm not cutting down very deep, I'm just cutting enough away that the ink will not pick it up. So it doesn't need to be deep at all. This is quite rigid. It's rigid enough that the ink will just lay on top of it and not get down into those grooves. So you can actually get really fine little lines. They'll come out. Hey Latendris, thanks for stopping by. Have a good night. Even Call of Duty paintings, so serious painting. Yeah, I think serious painting is probably rare on Twitch. I don't know what I would call not serious painting, but I guess... I think everybody does what they do thinks that it's serious, so... Choice of subject matter, that's just a matter of opinion, I think. But I guess fan art, I don't know. As long as that's what your idea is, as long as that's who you are and that's what you want to do, then it's true, you know? Genuine. Look at that. See those windows over there? They're not perfect. And these angles are off, but you know, it's there. Still want to straighten this one out. I kind of did this one to start with and it was not great. But I also don't want to destroy it in person. Mr. Creep, hey, how's it going? Welcome, my friend. Slowly but surely, the A La Prima crew are showing up. Mr. Cree. Amazing artist. Rezzo, amazing artist. Both here. Guys, I'm just gonna... let's see, Yaga Prima. There's all the, there's the links to everybody who is part of the Alla Prima stream team. Give them all a follow. They're all really good. All genuinely good people. Fun people to watch. Good artists. Yeah, and Mr. Creep, I love your new overlay. Have you unveiled that? Sorry, I'm not, hope I'm not spilling the beans. Shouldn't say anything. Keep my mouth shut. And the feed? Oh, the feed! He's, I haven't added him yet. Thank you so much, Taco. Yeah, there's been a lot of cool kids here in the chat tonight. Like, so many. Got Fiend here. Taco Mate. Got Chloe. Got Trio. Trio's been here. Trio Gaming. 0414. Who else have we had here? We had Chip Whitehouse. Chip Whitehouse was in the house. Where are Huey Lewis and the News from? Are they from Cleveland? They don't even mention Cleveland in this song. Anybody out there know anything about Huey Lewis in the News? Can you bestow your knowledge on me? If you've ever read the book American Psycho, you maybe picked up a little bit of knowledge about sports. Huey Lewis album. There's like a whole chapter intro about this, that album. It's funny. Trying to get my lines worked out here. Oh, I guess they mentioned lots of cities in the song. Wikipedia says San Francisco. Ah, oh, right on. I love San Francisco bands. So many San Francisco bands. My favorite one, Faith No More. Metallica, obviously. Journey. So many great bands. Oh, you're about to post the same thing. Wikipedia says San Francisco. I need to add Phoebe. I've got to remember to add Phoebe to my thing. Oh yeah, Corey Hart. Yeah, Stig Lebowski, I love being on the big screen. The big screen. I like getting the big treatment from the dig. I'm wondering what I should do to make your viewing experience fun while you're on the big screen. just funny. I'm listening to the music through one headphone, and this song is like stereo panned extreme left and right, so I can only hear half the song. My hands, they used to be big, strong hands. Aw, Fiend, thank you for the host. I thought you were already hosting me. Am I mistaken? Didn't you host me earlier? Thank you. Either way, thank you so much. I thought you were too. I think you were. Maybe you just went away for some reason. Fiend, did you stream today? And when did you do that owl piece? I love it. It's awesome. But I kind of love it because, partially because it reminds me so much of Labyrinth. Also, it's just cool. Don't be afraid of a guy in shades, oh no. Cause you got it made with a guy in shades, Alma. I'm trying to interpret these lyrics. Don't be afraid of a guy in shades, oh no. You got it made with a guy in shades, oh yo. Didn't stream today, did the owl yesterday, right on. Didn't feel enlightened today, let's see. Well, you have to have the motive, you have to be ready to put yourself out there. It's exhausting sometimes. Shit, did I just go through the back? No, I didn't. Thicker at the top. Thank you. Your lamp over your drawing table burned out? Oh. I see. That's what the Enlightened was all about. Dig with his play on words. I should have guessed. Is it just a light bulb problem, or is it the actual light he's replacing? Joker, Kay, how are you? Welcome, my friend. Thank you for the host.
This way.
I'm good, thank you. How are you, Joker? How's everything going? I haven't seen you for a long time. Hope you're doing well. Doing alright? Long time no see? Yeah, totally.
Tactics.
You're back, scrounge the fridge for food? No problem, Joker. Hope you find something good. Yeah, this should be cool when it turns out, hopefully. Hopefully it'll print as well as it... because I hope it does. This is the thing, you can spend a lot of time and do a lot of work and not quite know how it's gonna look, but if... I mean, I got a general sense. I think I got a general sense how it's gonna look. That was for you, Fiend. Oh yeah, Slaughter. Let's hear that voice, Mark. Mark Slaughter. Yes, Slaughter. It'll turn out like sorcery.
Thank you.
I think this blade is actually starting to get kind of dull. Doesn't seem to be taking these little pieces off as well as it was when I started. But what can you do? Gotta keep going. I think I'm gonna try to finish this side over here. And then next time I'll just finish this dude. I'll see how far I can get in the next like half hour. be a mod. Yeah, I don't know what happened to Noxel. I think she was just really busy.
Yeah!
What was that movie with Tom Cruise and like about like the 80s rock hair band scene, like the musical? And Whiskey Go Go and all that. I can't remember what the name of that movie is. But I'm just thinking that Chloe probably loves that movie. That's all I was thinking about it. Did you love that movie, Chloe? And the musical, of course. The musical was on Broadway at the West End here for a long time. Because I think the song is featured in it quite a bit. Rock of Ages, that was it. You want to wear acid wash jeans and do some burnouts in front of high school when you listen to this song, that's awesome. Also, rock a mullet. Yes. Got a Firebird taco. You guys are awesome. I want to see that. I'd give anything to see that.
Say we kick some ass.
Kicking ass. Yeah, you heard your name, Chloe. I was asking if you liked the movie Rock of Ages and the musical Rock of Ages with Tom Cruise and all. Because this song's in it, I'm pretty sure. You don't think you've seen it? What? Chloe! Chloe, make sure you watch that forthwith. You will love it, Chloe. It's all the music you love. Like, literally, probably all the music you love. It's like Bon Jovi and Guns N' Roses and Poison and Motley Crue, and it's all sung by like an awesome cast of both like comic actors and Tom Cruise and other actors like that, you know. And it's really good, man. It's so much fun to watch. I liked it anyway. I had a lot of fun watching it. It's got Journey, they do some Journey songs in it. Yeah, Tom Cruise, totally. Hey, Deviant, how are you? Haven't done this since high school. It's not just for high school, you know. A couple people have mentioned tonight that this is, you know, something they did in high school. It's kind of like, you know, looked at as a... Nowadays, I think it's looked at as kind of like an arts and crafts kind of thing. But it's definitely something, a form, you know, a form of art you can express yourself with just fine. And it has a really nice effect. And it takes a lot of, it takes skill to get good at it. So, you know, it's got all the makings of proper art. Thanks, Dig Lebowski, for the host. Thank you so much. Not that, you know, other forms of art are not proper art. I'm just saying that it takes skill and craft and combination of a number of things that I think make a piece of art really something you can sink your teeth into and look at and go, wow, that's kind of a nice fusion of ideas and technical craft and skill and expression, you know. Never had the press to do it. You don't have to have a press. I don't have a press either. You don't have to have a press to do this kind of printing. Now I've done intaglio printing, like on zinc plates, like metal plates, copper plates, where you actually use acid to etch rather than carving. Those ones definitely take a press, because you can't draw the ink out of the grooves, because that's the process where you put the ink in into the grooves, wipe the rest of it off, and then print the line work. This is, however, just rolling ink onto the surface, flipping it over onto a piece of paper, or putting a piece of paper down on it, and then rubbing it, and then pulling the paper off. So, next time I stream, I'll finish the cut and I'll do a print, maybe a few prints. And you can reprint over and over and over. And, you'll see the process, but I'm sure you did it in high school, so you probably ring a bell when you see it. Depending on how long ago our high school was, you know. But, you know, I wasn't saying that it wasn't proper art at all. Like, just the fact that people have mentioned that they did it in high school, and that's the only time they did it, kind of gives the impression that it's not something that people do seriously. But it is. Definitely is. Can be done seriously. It's kind of a lost art, though. I think people don't do it enough. I don't do it enough. I definitely don't. Soon as I wake up, every night, every day, and takes the dreams away. It must be love, love, love. Then etching using aluminum sheets, that definitely requires a press. Yeah, totally. Thank you. Yes, Chloe, I've watched The Young Ones. I love The Young Ones. I watched all of it quite a long time ago, but I watched it all, like, at one point, about 10 years ago. So funny. So trippy. Yeah, and, yeah, Madness played on it once. Madness, I think they played this song, maybe. Or was it, Our House they played? But yeah, they appeared on there. Good call, good shout, Chloe. I like your style, Chloe. Chloe's in the coolest shit.
Reduction the price of beer. All the people you meet are really rich. They don't care enough to eat.
No shit. I was just fine with all the streaming until just now. After 2 hours, 2.5 hours. Yeah, it's been laggy for a lot of people, I know. I'm buffering quite a bit. Yeah, I'm dropping frames. But only just recently, just for just a little bit of a spark. Seems like it's calmed down for a sec. Thought it was the snow lagging you out again. No, it's been happening to a lot of people on Twitch. But I've been fine for the last 2 hours, 2.5 hours, so I'm hoping it'll calm down again. Fingers crossed. Soon we have a problem. Refresh. You guys refresh. Okay, Amber, thank you so much for being here. Pack South. What's going with Pack South? Not Chip Whitehouse, I like it. Guys, things seem to have stabilized for me. I hope it stabilized for you too. I think it was just a little blip there, hopefully.
I can't get to sleep. Thinking about the implications.
I can tell where I started on this because right here I cut the wrong thing out.
Oh, okay.